Martin Duddy, consultant neurologist from Newcastle. So this is an exciting time for people with MS. If we think about relapsing remitting disease, we are just on the cusp of getting a couple of new drugs. So cladribine is a tablet that's used in MS, given an interesting way where you take 2 weeks 1 year and 2 weeks the next year, and then the data might suggest that 2 years therapy is good for 4 years. So a very small course of treatment with quite a long-lasting effect. So that has been through the EMA and has just been approved by NICE, so we really should be starting to prescribe that quite soon within the UK. It's going to be used for people who have failed on a first-line treatment, and it does seem to be more effective than some of the earlier therapies. Just after that then, ocrelizumab very recently has just been given a nod that the EMA are going to approve it for relapsing remitting disease. It's highly effective in relapsing remitting disease with the kind of efficacy we see with other antibody treatments like Lemtrada or Tysabri. So we've got to see what the EMA, the exact wording of the license, and then it's got to go through NICE, which we're expecting next year hopefully. So that's two big new drugs very close together, which is an exciting time. So for progressive disease, this has been really the dawn of the treatment era. So ocrelizumab came through with the first drug ever shown to work in primary progressive disease. This is a drug which works very well for relapsing remitting disease and seems to treat some of the inflammation that probably comes early on in primary progressive disease. And we see roughly a 20% reduction in disability with that drug. So we are waiting to see the precise wording of the license to know which people with MS will be eligible for it under the license, and then in the UK there's then a big hurdle of that getting through NICE, and we're not sure how that's going to go. Another drug that has shown promise then is biotin. So this is a high dose of a vitamin, and you can buy the vitamin over the counter, but this is 30,000 times the recommended daily intake, and especially formulated tablet. And we see with that in people with a mix of primary progressive and secondary progressive disease that they actually saw an improvement in a number of people over the first year of that, and that seemed to be sustained over the next couple of years of follow-up. So again, that's one that is with the European Medicines Agency at the minute. We're waiting to see whether that will be approved or whether they're going to ask to wait for the results of a second trial. And then the third drug, which is kind of just on that cusp, is a drug called siponimod. This is very closely related to Gilenya that we already have for relapsing remitting disease. Again, this has been shown to work in people with secondary progressive disease and reducing the rate of progression disability by about 20% over a two-year study. So this is the first drug that seems to work in secondary progressive disease with or without relapses. There's a small trial showing it's also very effective, like Gilenya, in relapsing remitting disease. So we're looking to see where that drug is going to be positioned. But say this really is the first time that we've seen anti-inflammatories work in progressive disease, and then with a drug like biotin, this is a vitamin that maybe helps the metabolism of suffering cells and have an effect as well. Along with the kind of new drugs that we have coming along, all of which are new molecules and likely to be very expensive, there's also been a lot of work being done on drugs that are already around to see if we can repurpose them into MS. And the one that's probably come furthest is simvastatin. So we already have a positive small trial in about 140 people showing that it seemed to slow the rate at which the brain shrunk in progressive disease, and a very encouraging indication of resultant disability. So just now, as we speak, that's getting set up, and a bigger trial is getting rolled out around the UK, the MS-STAT2 trial. So it's actively recruiting people with secondary progressive MS. There's a lot of centres in the UK involved, so people do want to get involved. They can probably, a centre near them will be doing it. There are other small molecules being looked at as well. There's the MS Smart study, again UK-based, coming from UCL, which is looking at fluoxetine, riluzole and amiloride. Again, cheap drugs that are used for other reasons already. We know they're safe, we know you can take them for years, now being looked to see whether they work in MS. We're hoping to see the results of that trial next year. And then there's another drug called ebutalast, which is an asthma drug that's been used in Japan. And again, we've just seen the results of a phase 2 trial in that, showing a very significant effect on slowing brain shrinkage in people with progressive MS, and also improving the integrity of that brain and MRI scans. So a lot of small molecules, drugs that are out there, and the excitement here is that we don't need to do big expensive safety studies or long term, because these are drugs we already know.